It's a stereotype to think that canvases can only be found on art museums. Today's story is about the brilliant paintings on the walls that have changed that stereotype.
What does doodling on walls bring to your mind? In our childhood, it was a fun prank that we did behind our parents' back. But you know what? The discovery of what could be humanity's first doodles was also made by a group of kids. The encounter with the Lascaux Cave paintings, accidental as it might seem, was in fact destiny. Four French teenagers stumbled upon the drawings during the secret adventure. It was then that the ordinary cave walls turned into a beautiful canvas. They represent a great tradition that distinguished humans from animals. Could the ancient civilizations have imagined just how important their drawings would become? Today's journey is about looking for traces of that great tradition. A special journey that begins in this cave.
I really find fascinating that the people before here was able to draw such a beautiful paintings here in the caves. And probably this place before being discovered, I don't think they were meant to be last for so long. So I found really amusing and really amazing.
Here's a young man who has staked his life on graffiti. Welcome to my
zone. I like green.
Let's go.
Oh, okay. But I don't know how to put this.
Okay. Put it on your back hat.
In my back hat?
Yeah.
Like this?
Okay, got it.
Does it look funny?
No, it looks cool.
I don't want to look funny.
Spray paints and a mask are his tools. The scale of his drawings puts to shame my doodling in the soil with a stick. I want to learn more about graffiti.
Graffiti writer는 벽에다가 그림을 그리는 사람입니다.
Shim Chan Yang has recently emerged as the hottest name in Korean graffiti.
It looks much cooler than just fine art.
Okay.
The root of graffiti can be traced back to ancient murals of the drawings found amidst the ruins of Egypt. But just as those drawings are no longer considered just scribbles on walls, graffiti too are recognized as art by many. Perhaps it's not surprised that it was a tough job for a beginner like myself.
It looks kind of easy, but it actually requires a lot of skill. Is that good?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good enough.
He had once turned to theology, but he was destined to pick up the spray cans again.
Why did you start doing this? What was the reason? Like,
doing this meaning.
Yeah.
Because it's so much fun.
It is fun? Yeah.
I was a hip-hop fan.
Oh, okay.
So that's how I started. It looks much cooler than just fine art and usual painting, so.
Yeah.
For a nameless graffiti artist, drawing was far from the classiness that one normally associates with art.
Hindujo, yeah, well, 다 힘든 것 같아요. 사실 작년에는 상황이 진짜 안 좋았었거든요. 뭐 돈을 한 달에 한 20만 원이라도 벌면은 살만하겠다 이런 생각을 했었어요. 뭐.
He had to work for a month just to draw on the walls once. The trip to the U.S. was his last hope.
미국은 어렸을 때부터 계속 가보고 싶었죠. 그러니까 그래피티가 시작된 곳이고 힙합이 완성되는 곳이라고 생각하거든요. 딱 비행기 티켓을 끊을 수 있는 돈이 생기자마자 미국 티켓을 끊었어요.
Thankfully, hope really did await him. Brand new music.
그래피티는 사실 그쪽 문화에서 온 거예요. 그냥 길에서 스트릿에서 온 거고 우리가 그거를 기억해야 된다고 생각을 하거든요. 그리고 그 사람들은 스프레이로 그림을 그리는 거를 돈 벌기 위해서 하는 게 아니라 자기 돈 써가면서 그 문화를 지키고 있는 사람들이어서 저는 그 사람들을 되게 존경하고요. 제 그림이 그래피티 전부가 아니고 되게 작은 일부분일 뿐이고 그래피티가 이런 쪽도 있고 저런 쪽도 있다는 걸 좀 다양하게 이해를 하실 수 있다면은 저는 문화 자체에 큰 좋은 바람이 올 수도 있다라고 생각하고 있고 저는 제가 그 역할을 하고 있다라고 생각해요.
He also realized what he most draw.
와,
오 잘한다.
Wow, this is the famous picture. This is the famous painting of you. Wow,
one of the famous.
So pretty. How long did it take you?
2 days and a half.
2 days and a half. Wow, that's an amazing work there, by the way. Wow, I mean like. For example, why is a foreigner wearing a hanbok here? Why would you do that?
Why black people wearing hanbok?
I was a foreigner wearing hanbok. 그 사람들에게도 제가 선물을 주고 싶었어요. 제가 받은 것처럼. 그래서 내가 줄 수 있는 게 뭐가 있을까 생각을 했을 때 한복이 제가 줄 수 있는 진짜 선물이라고 생각을 했어요. 제가 한국 사람이니까.
Graffiti artists see themselves as writers rather than artists. To them, graffiti is their message to the world and their identity. And what helps Shim stand out from all the graffiti artists out there was his identity as a Korean. Art that is open to all. Graffiti is a familiar subject, bringing back memories of the drawings I did on the walls as a kid. Something that I can enjoy to my heart's content.
The Louvre Museum and the Pompidou Center in France, the Tate Modern in Britain, and the Museum of Modern Arts in the United States. Can you spot the similarities? They're globally known museums and galleries that eagerly held graffiti exhibits. Without a doubt, graffiti is the trending subject in today's modern art scene.
But things change when graffiti is placed inside a gallery. Some things are more beautiful in their raw state when they are right where they belong. Some praise art as the act of refining one's soul. But to me, it is something that can be enjoyed in any way that I see fit. Just like graffiti, free from all formalities.
But there used to be a time when graffiti was the cause of a headache for many cities. Considered as both art, but a nuisance. Graffiti was born in a street like this, so naturally, the most suitable revenue for them to be exposed is the street, not a gallery.
The outer wall of this building became a canvas for some and a piece of silk for others. Perhaps art is the ability to look at the same things from a different perspective. The fourth artist to fill this wall is someone who brightens up the gray world with his unique alphabet lettering technique. His name is Ben Aine. A living legend in the British graffiti scene. His work created what's known as Alphabet Street and the concept of shutter art. What does graffiti mean to him?
Okay, basically, nobody goes to art galleries. Nobody goes to museums. Like, what percentage of the population goes to an art museum? You know, everybody, lots of people are intimidated by art galleries, intimidated by museums, they don't feel comfortable going there. So, you know, in the street, you know, you don't have to queue up, you don't have to know about the artist, you don't have to feel intimidated. You literally, you walk down this hill and you go, wow, that's nice. And then you go to work.
Right.
And that's the beauty of painting in the street and painting in, like, the public domain.
An art gallery doesn't always have to be a fancy atelier. That is his unwavering belief. He chooses the nozzle over a paintbrush and lacquer over paint. And the walls are his canvas.
Yeah, MC?
Yeah?
Have we got any more red down there? Madrid red? Yeah, baby.
Yeah.
I still got it.
To Ben, no atelier can replace the streets where countless individuals can meet his work.
Like, you know, that wall is boring, and this wall is fun and exciting. And yeah, I think anything, a splash of color on a wall is better than a boring gray city. So this building is going to look amazing. It'll be the best building, yeah, it will be the best building in, you know, in Korea. Finish!
There was a time when a beautiful artwork brought out the urge in me to own it and display it in my room, but not anymore. After all, true art is something that needs to be shared, not owned. journey in search of great drawings has brought me to a very old neighborhood, a place that is known as Korea's Brooklyn. What would I see on those streets, lined with shoe stores? Yoo Hong-sik has been making shoes from a very young age. I'm sure he knows this area better than anyone else.
Hongakoe 지금 해수로 56년, 만 55년 됐어요. 와, 천지가 개벽을 했죠. 내가 16년 전에는요, 여기에 전부 공장들 뿐이었어요.
His handmade shoes haven't changed a bit, but the streets he walks every day definitely have.
70년대 되면서 이제 공장, 도로, 정비 사업이 들어가게 됩니다. 그러면서 공장들이 지금 남아있는 2층, 3층 벽돌 건물들이 들어서게 되게 되는 거죠. 그래서 그 건물들이 지금 다시 도시재생이라는 이름으로 재탄생해서 노후된 건물이 새로운 모습으로 변신을 해서 다양한 카페나 이런 용도로 사용하고 있습니다.
This old neighborhood first wall drawings appeared in 2014. Since then, Songsu-dong has rapidly gained popularity, no longer just a forgotten place.
네, 이제 이런 건물을 보니까 낡았던 건물인데 새로 고쳐서 청소도 하고 지금 창문 같은 경우도 굉장히 이제 조형적으로 바꿨어요.
그래서 좋네요.
제가 추측하기로는 굉장히 이제 건물이 새로운 모습으로 바뀌었는데 뭐 미술이라는 것과 그리는 것도 있겠지만 이렇게 이제 건축물 같은 것들을 이 공간에 잘 어울리게끔 고치고 하는 것들도 사실은 미술이라고 보고 예술가들의 동료라고 보입니다. 그리고 미술이 아주 많은 사람들에게 이렇게 경험할 수 있거나 이러기 어렵다는 거죠.
Song Ju-chul is a public art expert.
시골 같은 경우는 뭐 예술이나 문화 자체가 소외 지역이라고 봅니다. 그래서 저희 같은 이제 미술을 하는 사람들이 그런 데 찾아가서 함께 나누는 거죠.
Graffiti may be a gift to their admirers, but a form of violence to those who do not welcome them. But to the residents of Songsu-dong, at least, they were a blessing.
혹시 우리 크리 시장 씨 삼촌 같으시지 않으세요?
약간 그런 느낌이 나요.
네, 그래서 그 노동하는 분들에 대해서 이렇게 굉장히 그 노동의 가치 같은 것들을 노동자라는 그림을 통해서 표현하는 것 같습니다. 그래서 아까도 말씀드렸다시피 이제 사실은 최근 이제 벽화나 그래피티 같은 것들이 약간 부정적인 면도 있습니다. 이게 뭔가면은 대중들이 좀 호응하고 쉽게 이해할 수 있어서 많이 그려주다 보니까 내용이 좀 없는 벽화들도 간혹 있어요. 근데 특히 그래피티 같은 경우는 내용을 담고 있지 않는다면 이게 어떤 사회적 공예로서의 낙서가 될 수도 있는 우려가 있기 때문에 예술성을 충분히 갖고 있어야만이 이게 이제 어떤 거리 예술로서 공공 미술로서 사명을 다할 수 있다.
An old railway sleeper, at least half a century old, has been turned into a one-of-a-kind interior item. while a worn Durns stands as an antique table. Here, the lives of all things are renewed.
Well, it was a really fun experience for me to come to this place, and what I find really interesting about this is like all the buildings here, the neighborhood itself is really old, but thanks to these pictures, it's just getting younger and younger. That's the feeling I got. And being with Professor Song with this all the time, it actually felt like like spending time with my dad.
These great artworks can only be enjoyed at night. They're indeed a breathtaking sight.
주로 낙타를 가지고 작업하고 있는데 사막이라는 현실에 낙타가 이제 현대인이 되는 거거든요. 네. 낙타의 혹이 우리가 짊어지고 있는 짐이고 그게 또 생명수도 된다라는 의미에서 네, 작업.
I was invited to this special exhibit by Yoon Song Ah, an actress and a painter. She actually specialized in oil painting. So what pushed her to come out to the street as a graffiti artist?
I mean, you have a lot of places, especially here in Seoul, to like show your art, right? Mm-hmm. But why would you choose to a building, right?
갤러리에 많이 오진 않으세요. 네. 그리고 오더라도 아 미술은 어려워라는 생각 때문에 그냥 쓱쓱쓱쓱 보고 지나가요. 근데 어느 날 그런 거에 대한 굉장히 회의감이 들고 외로움을 느꼈을 때 왜냐면 나는 이만큼 에퍼트를 넣고 정성을 넣고 사랑을 주는데 돌아오는 피드백은 요만큼인 거예요. 그래서 아 미술을 어떻게 하면 좀 쉽게 사람들한테 다가가고 조금 더 표현될 수 있을까 라는 생각에서 여러 가지 이제 프로젝트들을 진행을 했었거든요.
Her words conveyed the depth of her loneliness. For a long time, I thought about what she said. What good are plays without an audience, and books without readers? In the end, what bridges life into art is an audience who understands and appreciates its true value. To be artistic is to stimulate the hearts of others. Creation of art is something that can be done only by humans, but the same goes to recognizing its true value. Mere drawings on walls become great only when they are discovered by humans who can see their true value.
The Altamira cave paintings left behind by Mickey thousands of years ago are a legacy that differentiate the artistic men from animals. Graffiti too, are priceless artwork that will prove the existence of today in our future posterity. A tradition that will be remembered as an artwork that was enjoyed, not possessed as many as people as possible.
I will draw as much as I can, for as many people as I can, for as long as I can. Kit Herring.